Hi, welcome to the Silver Life. So I went to the garden shop and it's very gray outside. It's cloudy, it rained a little bit. Mosquitoes are biting my neck. They don't always bite. So I went to the garden shop. So I want to do a little garden haul. Show you some of the things I got right over here. So we're going to go through it and I'll show you one at a time, because my garden that I'm doing on my front side of the house, as you can see behind me, there's a lot of trees on my property and on the houses around me, and therefore I have a lot of shade, so I have to find something that works in the shade and can give me a little bit of color. So here we go. The first thing I found was these coleus. This is a sunshade coleus. So this means it's coleus is a shade plant, but now they hybridized them where they can take a little more sun. So this one, I got this one because my neighbor gave me a pot of coleus and it had a lot of this color in it. So I went back and I got two more of these, and I got like three of these, so I can put them together and they will complement each other. I'm making a new shade garden. I'm taking out the, well, I'm not taking out the grass. The grass is literally dying out because it doesn't grow in the shade. So I got that one, and then I also got this coleus. Isn't this one beautiful? It's like a lime green color. It's called Mainstream Rodeo Drive. That's the name of it. Mainstream Rodeo Drive. Isn't that beautiful? It has a little, the beautiful fringes on all the coleus, but around the fringes, it's a dark color. That's the same color as this. So they're going to all be great together. Some kind of way I'm going to put them in there, in that area, so they can complement each other. So I got three of these. And then it's always good to have impatiens. These are old school common impatiens. And I got the, you know, it's a multicolor pack, six pack. And makes little plugs. And it's going to make a little bush. So this is going to go probably in the front. And then these will go behind it, because it's going to be taller, so it'll be a lot like that. Maybe. We'll see. That's how I'm hoping. And then, this is a regular impatient. This is a New Guinea impatient. And it's so pretty, right? And this one is a red, New Guinea red. And I love this one because this is the color the bloom starts out a little bit lighter, and it's going to turn and go to this color with the variations in the little petals. And then the stalk, the leaf stalk, is it has red or purple in it. So, but I'm going to put this in a pot, in a shade pot. I also have to find something to put in my pots that are out here in the shade. So the sun is easy. Shade is very hard. So the other thing I got, I decided that I was going to put, I'll start collecting hostas. This hosta, this is guacamole. This one is very popular, guacamole, and I've seen it where people have it and it gets huge. So this is actually the coleus it won't come back every year. It's called an annual. This is a perennial. And it grows in a mound. Like, and it just keeps spreading. I love this one. I'm going to try to start collecting them. And so I started with this guacamole. I only got one of these. I'm probably going to go back and get some more. Hopefully it's going to be a sale. But this one already, right here, you can see where there's another one already spreading in this pot. So they're going to, that's what they go out and come up and go out and come up and make some mound. It's going to be pretty. Only thing is, some parts, the guy that cut my tree, I asked him, specifically asked him, not to cut holes in my tree because this was a shade garden. He cut holes in it. So now I have a lot of spots where it gets sun in the heat of the day, which I was out last year running around with the water hose trying to keep it from burning up some plants and moving them. The ones in pots, moving them. So that's a hard thing to do. But anyway, people do what they do. This one right here, I love this one. It's beautiful. It's called Fragrant Dream. And it's going to get flowers on it. I don't know what color the flowers are. I think they're blue. I think the little blooms, the spike that comes up is blue. I think. I'm not really sure. But it blooms in the summer. And it's also it's fragrant. So this is going to be really pretty. And let me show you the difference. See the difference in the leaf? I love it. So I got two of these. And then I just went to the garden shop, my daughter and I. And last year, my daughter bought me this ligulera, this plant that I have been having a fit over, trying to find it everywhere. And she found it. We found it when she and I were together in the garden shop. So I went, and then she paid $25 for it. And I think she got it in a 3-gallon pot. And I was like, no, it's too much. And she was like, no, Mom, I'll get it for you if you want it. So she bought it for me. And I loved it. It grew so beautifully. It's a shade plant. And it gets, because it's in the shade, it doesn't get a lot of color. So you have to look at it. When you're dealing with shade, you have to look at it where you get, like, more texture, different textures and structure, shapes. And it creates interest in the garden, like the coleus. The coleus, it'll get a bloom on it, but the bloom, nobody cares about it. We just pick it off because it's really not anything to look at. But if you pinch the blooms, it'll keep bushing out, and you can get coleus in all kinds of the texture and the color in it, and this will give you color in your shade garden. So the other one, the plant that I got is this one. I don't even know if you can see it. the leaves look like a lily pad. Don't they kind of put you in the mind of a lily pad? A wild lily? It's called ligulera. It gets huge. This one is in a 1-gallon pot. It is called a leopard plant. I'll show you this. See? Wait. Can you see that? It's a leopard plant. It has shiny green foliage. It has bright flowers that emerge in the fall. And it's used for a ground cover or in a water's edge. Combine it with ferns, astilbe, and iris. So this will probably look really good if I can get some iris to grow with it. I have some iris over here, but I don't know if it'll work. So,
yep, that's all I got.
Oh, I forgot.
And then,
this is heavy. You see this? I know you can't tell what this is. This is really heavy. These are coffee grinds from Starbucks. You can go to Starbucks and you can usually, and they'll tell you if they participate in the program. Mostly all of them do now. My Starbucks, what they do is they found a place outside where they just leave the coffee grinds and people can just go and pick them up. So my husband went last week and we got 4 bags of this. I'm gonna go on Monday and try to see if I can get some more. You just take these and you sprinkle them in your garden. Your garden smells like a big Starbucks. It'll smell, if you love coffee, you're gonna love it. But the other thing is, it is so good for your ground, for your garden, for the dirt, and worms, earthworms love it. They come up to get it, so it aerates the soil, and so it's just a great thing. So if you whether you like coffee or not, what I do is, because I look at it as getting free fertilizer, so if I'm gonna get something for free, I want to do something for them. I don't drink coffee, but my husband does. So I go and my husband gets his coffee, and that gives him an opportunity to try out different coffees, because I'm buying it and he won't fuss about it. I don't want that expensive coffee. So I'm sorry, I was mashing those down. I get him a coffee, and then we go pick up the coffee grinds. It's a win-win. So you all, if you have a stop, if you go, even if you go to Starbucks, pick up your, see if you can pick up coffee grinds while you're there. And it is really a good idea. I know everybody has those Keurigs, but it's a good idea if you're a gardener, if you make coffee, to perk your coffee and then take your coffee grounds and throw them in your garden. I'm telling you, it does wonders for your garden. I do it every year that I can. The last couple of years, I've had problems in the civil life. I had some problems, but it's a great program, and it actually works. I use it. So that is my haul. This is a plant that's been sitting in a pot for over a year. I put it in this pot last year and I never did come get it out. That's what happens when you're in the civil life. I just want to throw that out there. But it lived in this little pot. This is the garden pot. I don't know. Sometimes I just can't get around to everything. The civil life is hard. So anyway, y'all have a good day. I love you. God bless you. Get outside. Go outside and get some fresh air. Even if it's gloomy, it's really nice out here to just sit. It's quiet. You hear the birds. The birds and doves are singing a song. But that's good. So everybody, get outside if you can. And God bless you in your civil life. I'm praying for you, and we all praying for one another. If you're alive, there's hope, so don't be discouraged. Bye.